Oh my God! Oh!
Woo!
Jesus!
Oh my God!
What the fuck, you funky
smear? Bro,
you better get out of here.
Hey, dude, what up?
Oh, man. What up?
Fuck.
You guys better get out of here. Hold your nose.
Woo!
Who farted?
Woo!
The greaser did it.
We've worked with the same directors, producers, basically, for a long time, so it was a little bit scary.
Isn't it, you know, that gay guy, Wayne Isham?
Yeah, the gay guy.
Yeah.
His butt buddy, Kurt Marvis.
Are we rolling, dude?
Yeah.
God damn.
Dr. Feelgood, it was fucking hot.
Yeah, it was our first video off of this album.
Mick, didn't you
hotter than shit,
fucking,
man.
Didn't Mick get all fucking pink and fucking...
Mick got roasted. A fucking desert.
That's right, for the tent. There's a scene in the video, you'll see there's a huge, like, circus tent.
We had to go see the tent.
Vince, we need to get a little closer to the fire because the fire's out of focus.
How about a little
because
fire?
We're not close enough to the fire.
And we got there right when they were taking the tent down.
Yeah.
Fucking great, man.
The chorus came first on that song. We didn't have any idea for it. The chorus came, as soon as he wrote that part, I remember I went. Call, Dr. Feelgood. That came real quick. The hard part was coming up with the verse.
It wasn't quite like it is now. It was a little more run together, and then everybody was sitting around going, we got a little more feel to it. So we started goofing with different feels, and it came out.
This is the first video off of our album, Dr. Feelgood, and this is Dr. Feelgood.
The motherfucking ass-kicking, ear-splitting, loudest tour on earth, Motley Crue 8990, in the back of Nikki Sixx's pick.
I was in hell on that one. Rockhead, we always turn around like every 2 seconds going, you're Russian, you're Russian, you're Russian, you're
no,
Russian.
No, I'm not, I'm American.
I'm an American.
It's hauling some fucking ass. It's like 120-something beats a minute. It's fucking pumping.
That song was like written in 5 minutes just on an acoustic guitar. Really sounded awful too.
Remember when we used to play the whiskey?
Something like this. Can you guess what it is?
The stage seemed huge. And going back there this time to play when we filmed the Kickstart video, it blew me away how small it really was.
And it was really kick-ass to be in the clubs again and have a number one album.
But back then we thought, wow, this is a big stage.
This is it, man. This is kickstart my heart. That was great meeting those people last night, man.
Yeah, it was cool.
That was happening.
It's heavy, man. They were all Magic Johnson, they're all coming up to us going, you're the crew. Yeah, really? You dig us?
He asked if I would wear his jersey on stage for him, and it was really cool. And I signed it. He wanted my autograph. Magic Johnson. Unfucking believable.
Without you?
Two ice cubes.
What?
I said two ice cubes.
I like it.
Okay.
But Mary was great. It was nice to have a female's point of view on the band.
She was cool.
What we did like about her, she'd done some surrealistic stuff, which was what we wanted to get for the Without You video.
It was stony.
This is third video, fifth album, called Without You. Check it.
When the shark
bites.
Oh, and you say.
Mary Lambert, she did the Don't Go Away Mad video. Like, I think she thought a little more about sex. I know she thought
a lot about sex.
Most of the time. Tommy brought back $500 worth of porno, bestiality, videos.
Dwarf fucking.
That was the heaviest.
God, that was fucking rude.
That was cool.
No!
No!
Don't say that, you guys!
Bart! Hey, wait a minute now. Everybody and their fucking mother can take us to fucking court and sue us. Fuck it.
Why not?
Here comes the real Motley Crue.
Fuck this shit.
Don't Go Away Mad's sort of like a Faces song. It was Motley just being like this. It's cool. You can see the sense of humor in the band.
Hey, this is the fourth video off of our album. It's about flesh and beating it. It's called Don't Go Away Mad. Just go away.
Broccoli inspectors.
Cleaning
carpet cleaners.
Carpet cleaners.
Rug doctors.
Broccoli inspectors. The typical Hollywood love story.
Yeah.
Boy meets girl. Girl meets girl.
Girl leaves boy.
Boy goes to newsstand, buys porno mag, and beats off.
Yeah.
Subliminal, but you God.
Nick Tommy came up with the beginning part, which is remember you're picking it with two fingers? Because
yeah.
He doesn't play, he plays just a drummer, but he picks at the guitar,
Like comes a cat.
Up, it's like like a cat. But he comes up with rhythm ideas. It's kind of weird. And it ended up being real hip.
They actually built a tunnel over the drums and pumped the drum sound out into this giant room and stereo mic it into this room. And that's really like Little Mountain Studios' little secret.
Not anymore.
This is called Same Old Situation. And if you listen real close, you know it's about Kitty Kitty.
A couple tracks for the Decade of Decadence album.
Hey, where are you going?
To hell.
Anywhere I want.
I'm going to the bathroom. Can we go now?
You want to watch?
Never happened.
Later.
Ciao.
Later.
Any famous last word?
See ya!